what happened? What's your first reaction?
Well, of course, sa mga nangyari, no, and if I would have been flying that day, parang denial stage ko na, no, this is not happening, because right after airborne, and for those as well approaching, biglang walang nakausap, wala nang nagko-control sa kanila. Mm-hmm. So there is that aspect na, of course, this is not happening, try the other frequencies, still try to talk to the controller. But unfortunately, the training had to kick in. We pilots are trained for this. No communication, so let's go for the lost communication procedure. But of course, on top of all, we are guided by the golden rule: aviate, navigate, communicate. Meaning, for pilots in incidences like this, in emergencies, they have to fly the airplane first, then navigate. Meaning they have to know their position, where they are at any given point in time, and then communicate. The last aspect, we couldn't communicate to the controller. So what happened, the pilots who were airborne at the time, they just have to communicate with other airplanes. Mm-hmm. So that they can be safe from others na. They will not be hitting each other, hindi magbanggaan. Mm-hmm. Yun yung nangyari.
So ganito yung accounts ng mga piloto who experienced?
Yes, the one that was so critical was the one from Clark, who literally took off, all right, and the last known instruction to him was runway heading, climb to 5,000. And supposedly, he will transfer to Manila approach for further instructions. Then, wala na. Then, the captain decided, we're flying into terrain. Straight to Mount Araya, to the area of Mount Araya. So he had to take a decision to come back and climb to a safer altitude. Yes, and then he was able now to talk to Philippine Airlines, who was also approaching naman Clark. Both of them were talking to each other.
Okay. Mm. Para sila na nandito ako sa point na to, nandiyan ka.
Yes. Yes, and then eventually the two coordinated and they landed safely into Clark.
Wow, galing nila.
Yes. Same then, there was another one who took off Manila right after, runway heading and 3,000 feet, but they realized that there was no communication anymore. They are going away. On a runway, on a heading, going away and going to dangerous altitude. They just have to turn back overhead Manila, 4,000. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That is the safe altitude over Manila.
So when you realize na wala pa nang kausap yung mga piloto, walang communication with the tower or the navigation, ano yun, sariling initiative nyo na huwag na ituloy yung mga flights?
Well,
mga succeeding flights?
Well, depends on your position at that time. For those who took off, yes, it would be safe just to come back. Okay. For those approaching, well, to the nearest airport, just come to the nearest airport. And those who took off in our airports in the provinces, they decided to come back dun sa departure airport sila. And those approaching, like, there was one I heard nasa FIR, just past the FIR, meaning the border from Vietnam and Philippines, nandito na sila. They just continued on. There was one coming from Japan who just at the FIR as well, at the border, decided to come back to Japan. That was the safest course for him. That was very good.
Okay. The head of the training,
yes.
How critical is CNS ATM during that time? Just so we passengers would understand how
It is so critical in a way that I would say it could have been a catastrophic event. There could have been an air-to-air collision between airplanes. There could have been a crash to terrain, but none of this happened. As I mentioned before, I can compare it to a maestro in the orchestra, and then suddenly the maestro collapsed. Now the musicians would be on their own, right? So that they can still continue on. And of course, safely, which is what happened. the training had to kick in, what we trained for. And of course, composure. You know, the pilots have to be in a composed situation.
Mm-hmm.
That is part of their training anyway, to be composed at all times. You know, stability under pressure and resourcefulness. Those top two, na, I would say, characteristic of a pilot.
Resourcefulness meaning?
Well, you have to make do with what you have at that point in time, which is your remaining communication. You can still talk to the other airplanes. Diba? Sige lang. Just talk to the other airplanes.
Mm-hmm.
It's a way, let's say, when the maestro collapsed, the one is guiding you. You just have to just maybe make signals. Now, okay, it's your turn, my turn.
Mm-hmm.
No. And then let's finish this. Bring everyone on the ground safely, which is what happened.
Thank you, sir, as a pilot. When you realize na wala nang kausap pala yung mga piloto nyo, yung you were informed na ganun, how do you feel about that? Is it something na nakakatakot?
Oh, yes, of course, yeah. Of course, what would come, what happened? You know, lagi yan. Ano nangyari? No, this is unprecedented in Philippines. This never happened before.
Mm-hmm.
To lose practically all the frequencies in approach in the area. Tower, there was still communication, but tower communication is limited range, only within the area.
Okay.
It could have been catastrophic.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Sir, before CNS ATM, we only have the Tagaytay. So parang bumalik pa tayo doon.
Actually, Ms. Chucky, even worse, because that Tagaytay also, I heard, was also not working at the time. That is the primary radar, what we call. No?
Yeah.
It's like, you know those radar in World War II that you just see dots? That was the one only working. You don't know the altitude, you don't know what that is. Is that an airplane? Is that a helicopter? Diba? Or a blimp? You don't know. It's the what we call the primary radar. It's just a dot there. No, that wasn't also working. Totally blind ang kaap, ang ATC or the truck controllers. They were totally blind.
Importante composure ng mga piloto.
It is, yes. You have to be composed. You have to be stabilized under pressure. Yeah. And know what to do. Yeah, the training should kick in. Mm. It is part of the training. Like for Air Asia, I can speak of it. We train the pilots every 3 months. Every 3 months. We go for recurrent training and we give them several scenarios. And one of which is like this, where we have some navigational failures, some radio failures, and then we just have to see that, okay, they are doing the right thing.
Mm-hmm.
Always on top of mind will be safety.
Sir, after this incident, naiisip pa ninyo na as pilots,
yes.
May doubts ba kayo kung safe pa ang Philippine airspace?
Well, let me put it this way. It is still safe, you know. But what we did now, proactively, I have to collate all this information that shared by pilots. We have safety reports. And now we have to incorporate it in a training. Best practices we will share. Some practices that can be improved on, that we will also share.
Mm-hmm.
I would say it's still safe.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and I think naman Kaap MIAA, they will now be putting their safety barriers after what has happened.
Ako kumbaga sana nag-prompt sa inyo na to kumbaga sana i-level up yung training.
Yes, to a relevant one. Kasi maybe guys, sabi ko kanina, it looks like it's an unthinkable scenario, but we still train for it.
Yes.
But now it seems na hindi siya unthinkable, right? So now let's make a regular training out of it. Maybe before you just visit this every 3 years.
Mm-hmm.
Now I think we will have to revisit it every year or every twice a year.
Mm-hmm.
I remember. Mm-hmm.
Any words, sir?
Well,
as a trainer, as a pilot,
all I can say is airlines will always have safety top of mind. All airlines for that matter. We are trained for this. And of course, apologies then to those who were affected by the disruption during that day. We had safety in mind first, and then of course the comfort of the passengers. That's why we did what we did. And also thank you to CAAP and MIAA for putting everyone together, the airlines and the other stakeholders. And at the end of the day, nothing catastrophic happened. You know.
Chaotic but not catastrophic.
It is chaotic in the airports, but not catastrophic. Yes, the NOTAM or the notice to airman, I am something around 11 a.m. already.
Sir, that was around 2 hours after that?
Almost 2 hours. I think it's because everyone was thinking that the system can be reset. Just like your a phone that hangs, right? You can say, I can just turn it off and on, then it should be okay. Yeah.
Pero 9 a.m. onwards, yung mga palipad pa lang, you decided na wag na munang paliparin because wala ka?
No. The exact event happened at 9:40 a.m. Those who took off, well, they have to deal with what they have, right? Anyway, they all went back safely. But those who were still on ground, yes, we have to keep him on ground. That's why I don't know if you heard that some of the passengers were kept in the airplane for a long time.
Yeah.
It's because, of course, the captains were thinking, no, this is just a glitch in the system. We can go anytime once the system is reset.
And the unexpected happened.
Yes. A bit like 10 hours before they were able to stabilize the system. It is. Actually, I would say that is the backbone of the aviation. That's the backbone of aviation in all over the world.
Before CNSATM, what were
you doing? They still had the same system, but it's more or less the same system, but it's not localized in Manila. It is localized in respective regions. Like example, used to be Manila will have its own approach. Clark would have its own approach. Bacolod, Iloilo will have its own approach. Cebu will have its own approach. Davao, Zamboanga, like that. Now, with the onset of the new technology, it was all put in one basket, so to speak, which is here in Pasay City. It's now the control of the approaches in several regions are now here in Pasay City, in CAAP compound.